Thank you very much, Lord Mayor, for your speech. Excellent. Thank you for your solidarity and support. I would like to welcome you all again. My name is Fatin Al Tamimi. I'm the National Chair of Ireland-Palestine Solidarity Campaign. We welcome you all here today for our Palestinian Freedom Conference, overcoming the ongoing Nakba. This great conference was organized by Ireland-Palestine Solidarity Campaign with trade union Friends of Palestine and our partners in Palestine. We're so proud and honored to be our partners in this conference, BADIL, for Resource Center for Refugees Rights. And we have Lubna Shomali presented here, one of our speakers presented BADIL in this conference. Welcome to all our great speakers from all around Palestine, different sectors, Palestinians and international speakers. And we welcome you all here today for this, the start of this conference. I'll just talk briefly about Ireland-Palestine Solidarity Campaign. We are the largest and longest established organization in support of the Palestinian all over the world. We support the Palestinians, proudly and honored to support the Palestinians all over in Palestine, the historic Palestine 1948, and Palestinians in the West Bank, Palestinians in Gaza under siege, and the Palestinians refugees everywhere around the world. We formed in 2001 and as a democratic, volunteer-based coalition of ordinary people committed to just and lasting peace to the Palestinian people. For over a decade, we have promoted the peaceful Palestinian-led boycott, divestment, and sanction, BDS, campaign for freedom, justice, and equality for the Palestinian people. And part of what we do mainly is raising awareness as well as following the BDS movement and other activities to be the voice of the Palestinian people in Palestine. We do, of course, organize this conference, and we do bring speakers to speak about themselves about firsthand witness of the occupation and the way the life in Palestine. We have today, I would like to welcome Al-Hajja Mayzouna. She is a Palestinian grandmother who came all the way from Palestine to tell her story. She came with a hope to tell you people of Ireland how she lived this, survived this Nakba. She's not a refugee herself. I'm gonna ask her here to come. Please welcome Mayzouna, and she's gonna tell us her story. I'm gonna translate. Mayzouna, welcome Mayzouna, please. Mayzouna came all the way from the occupied West Bank. As I said, she's not a refugee herself, but she married to a refugee. She's from the Al-Khadr village in the West Bank beside Bethlehem. She's going to tell us her experience. So please, Mayzouna, تفضلي يما.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Peace upon everybody here.
أيها العزيزين على قلوبنا وقلوب الفلسطينية.
People of Ireland, the people who Palestinian loves because of your support to the Palestinian people. I'm here and brought my regards and love from all the Palestinians in Palestine. And all welcome to us here, and I'm so honored and pleased to meet you all.
والله انا بدي احكي لكم عن النكبه لان النكبه كانت طفله صغيره يعني بس بتذكر يعني يوم احنا في الخضر يعني مش ما رحلناش
Well, I'm going to tell you about the Nakba, although I was too young at that time, but I do remember in Al Khadr village when the refugees started to come to our village.
بس أنا يعني شفت الناس يعني في الشوارع يعني ما فيش معهم ولا إشي ولا غطاء ولا إشي يعني.
I witnessed people coming, refugees. We're talking about the refugees who were forcibly removed from from Palestine, the historic Palestine, for the establishment of the state of Israel. So she witnessed these people, refugees, coming to the West Bank with no homes, of course, and they were sleeping roughly on the streets or if people would host them in Palestine, in the West Bank, in Al-Khadr village we're talking about.
أنا شفت الناس يعني اللي عنده غرفة ثانية يعني زيادة يأخذ لعيلة عيلتين.
So whoever has a spare room, he'll welcome some of these refugees. If they have a shed, they'll put them on the shed, just to welcome these people, not to leave them stay in the streets. Some of them were staying in the mosques.
Schools.
They put them in schools as well.
في ناس حرام بكو يروح يدور على الخلا على المغر يناموا ويقعدوا فيه يعني.
Some people looked for any shelter like caves or whatever just to stay. They thought they can stay for a short time and then go back to their homes.
يعني شحطة العالم وطولوا هم يا حرام هيدا شحطتين.
So all these displaced people were dragged from their homes to stay on the streets.
بعدين تولتهم ال الوكالة.
Then the UN started giving them tents.
بنت لهم خيام.
Gave them tents.
خيمة يعني كل عيلة خيمة.
Every family has a tent to stay in.
سووا لهم خيام في المطر يا حرام. الخيمة تطير من المطر عنهم تخليهم في السكعة. فيش لا كهرباء ولا مية ولا إشي يعني.
Just a small tent. It could be rainy, it could blow away by wind or whatever. People will have to stay and survive with these, living in these tents.
يعني مية ما فيش مية من العين يروح يمشوا عليها يعني يعني بجوز ربع ساعة نص ساعة تتصل.
There is of course no water, no toilets in the tent.
مية على روسهم.
They used to go walk a distance to get the water to drink and to wash.
يعني كهرباء ما في.
No electricity, of course.
يعني
no toilets, حمامات.
فيشي. Yeah. حمامات ما في.
No toilets.
يعني في المخيم كلة قد كبرة أربع حمامات بس.
It was
a
big camp, and there were only four toilets for people to walk over to use it.
بعدين أنا أجا نصيبي معهم أجا نصيبي أنتكب زيهم تجوزتهم
and my I don't know what you call نصيب but then my destiny yeah it came to marry one of these refugees so she married a refugee to get and she left in a tent with him
وتجوزت في خيمة زيهم
she got married in a tent
تجوزت في خيمة اتجوزت في خيمة وانتكب الزين يعني لا حمام ولا مطبخ ولا نطبخ على النار ونسخن مية على النار
So I married a refugee and I got Nakba. It's the same as a catastrophic person like them. And lived their refugee lives in a tent with no electricity, no toilet, no water, no cooking, nothing whatsoever, just a tent and a mattress and maybe a pillow.
تعذبنا شوي
فيها
سنتين في الخيمة.
So it was
لأني تجوزت 15 سنة.
Very harsh life in the tent.
ما جبتش أولاد في الخيمة.
I got married when I was 15, lived for 2 years in the tent. I didn't have any children at that time.
بعدين يعني بنت الوكالة للاجئين غرف صغار.
Then the UN started giving families rooms.
كل عيلة يعطوها غرفة ثلاث في ثلاث بس.
This room is 3 meter by 3 meter only. And every family will get one single room, 3 meter by 3 meter.
يعني هذه الغرفة لا في حواليها لا مطبخ ولا حواليها ولا إشي ولا حمام.
You live in this room with everything. It's your toilet, it's your kitchen, it's your bedroom, it's your TV room, it's everything.
يعني أنا في الخيمة في الغرفة هذه جبت خمسة.
I got five children in this single room. This room was everything to us. We had the five children in it. They were all to sleep in one mattress and covered with one blanket. Then my husband started working, so we built an extension. So we had a toilet and we built another room.
يما بدنا نحكي هلا عن المخيم وعشان الوقت بدنا نحكي
المخيم الحين
بعدين عن ابنك
بعدها المخيم الشحطت وصاروا هالناس يعني على كل حال اللي
of course at that stage the refugee camps settled kind of in buildings instead of these tents so started building these rooms and it got bigger of course and people started kind of settle but not settle because they're still looking to go back to go back to their homes and practice the right of return.
ما كانوا يطلعوا لهم يعني الوكالة تطلع لهم كل شهر يعطوهم شو هيد.
حكينا عن الاعتداءات عن المخيم يما.
يعني يطلعوا لهم هالكد كاسة رز كاسة سكر.
Then you used to give them just a cup.
كاسة عدس.
A kind of a pint measurements of rice sugar per month.
أوكي حمص.
احكي لنا على الاعتداءات على المخيم يما.
نعم.
يلا احكي.
بعدين يعني خلصنا يعني من الفكر وشدينا حالنا شوية. شبروا هالولاد شوية قامت الكيام على المخيم.
Then the children in the camp grow up and they started resisting the occupation. The occupation of course started invading the camp even grabbing more land as much as they can. So the resistance starting from the people from the الأطفال وبعدين
صاروا الأولاد يا حرام يروحوا يضربوا عليهم حطوا يعني حطوا قبر رحيلة بكت هذه يعني قبر رحيلة اسمها رحيلة قالوا هذه الرحيلة إن
So they start as I said they claim that there is a tomb in around beside the camp for رحيلة and the Israelis occupied that part so the people of the camp starting throwing stones at the Israelis and then it started how to occupy or invade the camp and arrest people tear gas and
يعني كل يوم مثلا عشان حطوها على جبل المخيم واستحلوا مطرحها صاروا الشباب كل يوم يروحوا يضرب عليهم حجاب
so they yeah as I said yeah حكيت هذا يما اوكي
يضرب عليهم حجار تمن صاروا يعتقلوا في الناس
they started the arrests frequent arrests
اللي عندها ولد يعني عندها كنابل مش عندها
so over have a son that means she can't sleep she can't have a peace of mind because she'll be worrying all every day about her son to be arrested by the Israelis.
يعني الشعب الفلسطيني يعني ذاك يعني اللوعة يعني من إسرائيل واحد يوم يجي يعتقلوا ابنها يعني ما يرحموهاش ولا يرحموا ابنها يقتلوه قدامها يعصبوا عينيه وربطوا يديه بالجنازير قدام امه وابوه
Palestinians suffered a lot especially mothers watching their sons being arrested harassed killed by the Israeli soldiers.
يعني خرب البيت.
They would come middle of the night during the day wherever they'll attack.
كل البيت يخربوا.
They'll.
بالسكاكين يخرب كل مع يعني صالونات إشي هاد كل يمزعوا.
They'll go to the homes and.
كسروا البيت ويأخذ الولد معصب يقتلوا قدام أمه يقتلوا قدام أبوه.
They will damage the house. They will call to the houses to arrest the boys, the sons, whatever, and then they'll damage the house as well. They don't just arrest; they humiliate the whole people in the house. They hit them, abuse them, and damage the whole house.
يعني الشباب يعني فاضت بكوا يعني يحضر بحجار يعني صار ضرب الحجر ما يزبطش معهم صاروا يتعلموا يروحوا يضربوا سكاكين يضربوا غير الحجار.
We have the right to resist.
Okay. بعدين الله مصلى محمد جاني الدور أنا في ابني.
Then my son was arrested.
راح الله يرضى عليه قتل هو ولد عمه ابن عمه قتل ضابط مخابرات.
Himself and his cousin, her son Nasser and his cousin killed an Israeli officer, Shabak officer, intelligent Israeli officer, and he was arrested and his cousin and put in jail and sentenced life sentence.
قتلوا يعني عذبوا حطوا يعني
احكي لي بعد ما رحت حرموك من زيارته
بكوا حط يعني حطوا في العزل وانا منعوني
they put him in jail they put him in a solitary compartment solitary jail and then they منعوك كم سنه يا ما
نعم
منعوك كم سنه تشوفيها
سبع they منعوني سبع سنين ما اشوفها
they didn't allow her to see her son for 7 years
صبتني جلطة على عيوني من كثر ما أبكي على ابني.
She got a clot in her eye and she can't see well. Till now she's not fully recovered from crying over her son.
بعدين بعد سبع سنين أعطوني زيارة واحدة.
After 7 years, they allowed me to see him. 7 years she hasn't seen her son.
وبعد هلأ ما صلى على سيدنا محمد. أعطوا صاروا يعطوني كل سنتين يعطوني زيارة بس.
Then they would started giving me a visit every 2 years.
قعد ابني 20 سنة في السجن تمني صرت أزوره زي الناس يعني. بعد العشرين صاروا يعطوني أزوره كل شهر كل 15 يوم.
After 20 years, they started giving me every month or 2 months to visit him once.
يعني تمني بطلت أشوف وبطلت أسمع زي العالم يعني.
But after what? After I can't see him well.
يعني قعدت 14 سنة تمني لمست ابني.
14 years. It took me 14 years to touch my son. She hasn't touched him
يعني
physically.
خششوني عليه من حد ما عبطته هيك أنا غميت ما دريت عن حالي.
That time when I first, after 14 years, when I saw him, I hugged him. I couldn't bear that. So I collapsed. I
بسحب فيا من ابني وأنا هي ضعفت ومغميان عليه.
I fainted.
أخذني
جندي
وطلعني برا. ما أعرف شو سويت في ابني شو بسته ما بسته الله بيعلم فيا.
I don't know what happened when I hugged my son. I don't know what happened. I just fainted. Then the Israeli soldier dragged me out of the prison. I woke up out. I don't know. I can't remember what happened. How if I kissed him, if I touched him, I don't know.
بعدها قعدت والله بيجي أخرى 8 سنين. بعد 8 سنين خششون عليه.
10 years after that, when I touched him again.
كل يوم إلى اليوم صورة أنا وياه شو رأيت شما مش متشتغمي كنت لا يوم ما بغماش.
They gave
إن شاء الله بشد حالي شوي.
They gave her permission to take a picture with him. So they organized that to take a picture with him. So he told her, Nasser told his mom before, Mom, they're going to allow you in to hug me and take a picture. Please don't faint. I want to see you.
بعدين اللهم صل على محمد عبطة والحمد لله وصورت معاه مليح يعني ما غيطنتش الحمد لله.
And I still have that picture.
وقبل يعني ما أضرب عن الأكل 40 يوم منعوني أشوف عشان بكيت أظني أحكي وأغلط عليهم.
قبل يما ولا بعد؟
لا هذا قبل ما يجي أنا بأسبوعين زرته. خششوني
لا على الإضراب قلتي.
لا الإضراب هم الأضرب مش أضرب 40 يوم.
Last year she's talking about the last year.
ربك ما ضرب ابني معهم.
Of course, the hunger strike last year. So her son was one of them, and she was so worried about him. She said he can't die any time without me seeing him. So she made a deal herself and her son, none of them to die before the other. Her son Nasser told her, "Yamma, don't die, don't leave me here. I need to come and see you, okay? I need to come out." And she told her, how can I, like if the angel death came to me. What shall I say? Just wait until Nasser comes out. So she is living that hope to for Nasser to come out. يما إيش بدك من الشعب الإيرلندي؟ احكي لهم كلمتين.
بدي ساعدونا ويقف معنا لأن ناصر هو يعني رافع رأسه من وراته. هو اللي قال لي يما روحي هذو الناس زينا.
I'm very proud of Nasser and everybody, every Palestinian should be proud of him. And he encouraged her to come. He was so happy to know that I'm going to Ireland. When she got the invitation, Nasser told her straight away, you have to go to Ireland, no matter what. The Irish people are great supporters and they are like us. It's the same struggle.
Nasser قال لي يما هذول زينة حبيبتي روحي. سلمي عليهم الجميع
وجميع الأسرى give them my regards and every single person in Israeli details
وتعلونا إن شاء الله
send their regards to you and they're all looking forward for Mayzouna to go back to Palestine to visit her son and tell all the prisoners the message from Ireland
وأهل فلسطين بسلم عليكم الجميع الله
يسلمكم all Palestinians Love you, Ireland. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.